Artemis, Greek goddess of the moon and of the hunt, protector of women and children, and killer of men who piss her off. From the time I was 5, I was trained to say that. I didn't know what it meant, but my parents made sure that the world knew I was able to say it. By age 14, it was as rehearsed as the smile on my face. It was plastered on like the makeup I used to try and erase myself. I was taught to wear my name like an armor. Claim it, and no one can use it against you, but there are some days that the anti-bullying lectures don't give you the tools for. Days when you sit in the back of the class, carving your name into the air, hoping someone will read it. Days when the class nerd with a goddess name curled under her covers with a flashlight, reading about the impossible women they teach you about in seventh grade mythology. Athena, the wisest woman to have ever lived. Artemis, the protector. Venus, the cunning. Pandora, the woman with the fate of the world on her shoulders. They were renowned for their strength. During homeroom, my teacher had me research my name. It was the first time I discovered I existed outside my own insecurity. I lifted my awkward eyes from the floor and took in the classroom for the first time. My oversized glasses slipped, and for just a moment, I forgot I was nerd. I forgot the rocks the football players threw at my face and the eggs the popular girls put in my hair, and I brandished my pen like Artemis's arrow, standing for the first time like my spine understood the word pride. I was Huntress, and with the bounding energy of a 14-year-old, I walked into my 7th grade history class and was taught that my strength was a myth. That the person I drew my strength from, the woman who hunted down the rapists of her followers and had them skinned, the woman who believed in herself, was the only lie I'd ever been told, because women like that don't exist. And sit down when you're in class and don't talk too much or people will be intimidated. I named myself Myth, and Myth had learned what it meant to be hopeless. So that night, Myth walked up the stairs to her room. And Myth made herself a cup of chamomile, and Myth played with a dog, convincing herself he was Pegasus, and Myth cried that night. And Myth didn't sleep that night, or the next. She spent the moon's hour reading stories and crafting herself into the goddess she was brought up to believe she would become. 3 days later, when Myth thought she'd be able to get a good night's sleep, she heard fiction's goddess voice from her slumber saying, "You, goddess, are the reason things go bump in the night. You are the woman people will be warned about. You are a warrior, walking through each day with sword carved of flesh and bone. You are the warning sign above the door, cautioning the naysayers and the disbelievers that a huntress takes no prisoners. You are worth more words than a myth can ever encounter. You're taught that myth means fable, fake. But you humans twist language with knives, hoping that the blade will make the words cut deeper. You are not myth. You are not me. Myth originated as mythos, the Greek word for story, so don't fall asleep yet. This story is yours. Pandora told me she left hope in your box. She's still waiting for you to take it.